Hello everyone, Laguna here with another video on Rise of Kingdoms. In this video I'm gonna talk about the Osiris League and the Ark of Osiris. I'm gonna talk about my experience and the experience of my alliance, Deadly Sins Pride, in the league. We reached the top 8, we reached the quarterfinals, unfortunately we lost. So I'm gonna talk about that. I'm gonna talk about the semifinals, who will I believe will win, who you should bet on, who I believe gonna win the whole league. Also, I want to express my opinion on the Osiris League and the Ark of Osiris in terms of the what is good and what should be changed to make it even better. So let's start and go right away at the schedule of the Osiris League to quickly talk about our match first. I'm sorry guys, it's still painful. My heart is in pain, it hurts, because I hate losing, but I hate even more when I know that if we had our normal lineup, we would have won. I'm sure of it. Unfortunately, we lost. Things happen. Our sub are not as good as JVM sub. There's a huge difference between the subs. I don't know why this power is shown as 2.8 when in reality they have 3.3, probably higher now considering the boost. So there's almost like a 1 billion difference between 60 players, which is insane. And it's not just about the power itself, it's about what the power represents. Because once you have like 80 million power, or even lower, I have a 70 million power, you don't really need many more troops. And even if you lose some troops, you can always compensate by healing. That's not a problem. The problems are the commanders. JVM is an alliance that has like 20 people over 100 million power with like 5 marches of legendary max. That's insane. They probably have 30 people with 5 marches maxed. So that's a huge difference, okay? A huge difference when we have people with 2 marches and so. But still, with the main lineup, I think we could have won. Unfortunately, it didn't happen. We have to accept. I need to move on. I move it on. And I want to say again congratulations to JVM, because what I said before is that I believe they are the strongest team in the league, because they are not just a team that plays with power, but they play with strategy. So they combine the two things. They have insane individuals in terms of power, and they have good strategy. I'm pretty sure they will beat everyone as well now. So honestly, I have no doubt they will not just win the semifinals, but they will win also the league. I mean, look at the scores against every team. They destroyed everyone. Actually, we played against them before as well in the group stage, but some players were missing and I was missing. And since I'm like the leader, the one that makes the strategy, the one that makes the calls in the game, most calls, I micromanage a lot. It's a bit different when I play and when I not play. So this match doesn't really count. This was the real match. Unfortunately, I repeat, we lost. Now let's move on to semifinals. The first is 1MB8 against JVM. Now, the 1MB8 has been able to be the strongest alliance of Kingdom 93, the kingdom of my friend the Billy, and is one of the two strongest kingdoms in the game, and they destroyed them. It's not easy for me to be honest now, because of I have friends there, because of Billy, but I have to say that they played really, really bad. I mean, they were good, NB were good, but they were really, really bad. So I don't know how much it counts. But they were able to beat MB1. They were able to beat MB1. MB1 is the main alliance, the first alliance of the same kingdom. They are in the same kingdom, of Kingdom 103. They are both in the same kingdom. They were able to beat them. And this alliance has the same amount of power individual as JVM. So they are very, very good. They play one of the best arc in the game, in my opinion. Yet, they are against JVM. And JVM play as well good. They will fix a lack that I saw in the last match in the middle, because they experienced with us that they can lose middle. So I think this time they will focus a little bit more on middle. And if they do that, honestly, it's gonna be a wrecking ball. That's what I believe. I'm sorry, because I know NBA people. Sabo is a great guy, he's a great leader, he's a great strategist, he's amazing. But in my opinion, this alliance is just too strong. So I would bet everything on JVM. They're gonna win this match, and they're gonna win the final. Whoever wins in the other semifinal, they're gonna win it all. I'm sure of it. But now let's see the other semifinal. MB2 against OV. I have to be honest here as well, I didn't really watch all the matches of these alliances. I watched against White Tigers, but like with LMFD, I think White Tigers very, very badly performed in this match. So I'm not taking anything out of OV, but I think, because they played good, but I think they played much worse than this guy played much good. They played very bad, White Tigers.
MB2, I saw them playing. They are fine.
They play a good game, a solid game. So honestly, really, this match is a 50-50% match. So what do we have to do in this situation? Let me go and see the bets. I'm curious. Considering that OV beat White Tiger by a lot, I suppose they will be the team that is voted the most. Yeah, and exactly what happened. And OV have more votes. So now, since it's a 50-50% match, they have pretty much the same amount of commander and power. Actually, MB2 have a little bit. They play both a good game. If I was you, I would bet on MB2. You know what? I'm gonna bet on MB2. 50-50% chance. And when it's 50-50, you have to bet. You have to vote for the one that gives you the most money if you win. In this match, I don't see any chance for one NBA to win. So I will go everything on JVM. I'm not going because there is no point. Also, I have already buffed everything, but that's what I will do if I needed coins. I will bet on MB2 and JVM. And in the eye of the talent, this one, I will bet if you didn't already on JVM because they're gonna win the whole league. And this is it. This is it to describe our match. And the semifinals and the finals and who is the best team in my opinion and so on. Now I want to talk about something else, about the suggestions that I have in mind to improve the Arc of Osiris and the Osiris League. Let's start from the Osiris League. What I believe should be done is to introduce a minor league. Teams that are not able to get promoted to the major league group stage, they will just get dropped in a minor league to make things a little bit better, in my opinion. Yeah. A little bit better, give a chance to low teams to fight and have a chance to actually win something. And then what I will do is to introduce the lower bracket and the best of three for the final. Lower bracket and best of three. Now the suggestions are for the Arc of Osiris, but some of them also work for the Osiris League. The first thing that I would like to see is a new map. I would really love if the devs will introduce a new map in the Arc of Osiris. Actually more than one, but let's start with one and up to 3, 4, 5 maps. And the cool thing will be that we don't know which map we're gonna play until we enter the match. Then we'll make everything much more harder, much more challenging, and things that are challenged to me are fun. You know, so you need to prepare for 3, 5 maps and you will not know what you're gonna play until the moment that you play. That's amazing. I mean, explaining the same thing to a lot of players with Slighty, and that's gonna be fun. Imagine explaining to 30 players or more a strategy that is works for one map, a slightly different challenge that works for another map. It would be awesome, very funny to do. Another thing that I really believe needs a fix absolutely are the shrines. The Shrine of War and the Shrine of Life needs to be changed. Why they need to be changed? Let's go to the structure and I will let you see why. The main structure, aside from the Arc of Osiris, the main structures, occupational structures, are the altars and the shrines. The altar gives 750 points and 150 per minute. The shrines give 400 first occupation and 80 per minute. So basically it gives like half, almost half the altar. The difference is that the shrines buff our troops. Which way? The Shrine of War gives a ridiculous 5% attack and defense. This is ridiculous at any level, at any stage of the game. It needs to be buffed. It can stay like this. It can stay attack and defense, but it needs an upgrade. So I will raise it to, I don't know, 50% attack and 50% defense. Maybe even 20% attack and 20% defense to make it worth. The Shrine of Life gives 20% healing speed. That's good for low alliance with not so much troops. So that will make a difference. That's decent. But for a league at the very top, let's say the playoff, the Osiris League, Major League, this should change because it's completely worthless. We have too many troops. We don't need to yell. And by the way, the things are now, if you see the matches, you realize that alliances don't really go for these shrines. Because what's the point to go for these shrines if the buffs are ridiculous when you can focus on the altar that gives double points? So if you want to make these structures worth to go for and to make more variables and to make the game better, you need to make them worth. Buff the Shrine of War, my suggestion is to 50% or 20% attack and defense instead of a ridiculous 5%. And either change the Shrine of Life just for the league or find a way to make it worth. Maybe add something like, instead of healing speed, you could do something like a debuff, like if you have the Shrine of Life and you attack a troop, you slow the troop by 10%, 15%, 20%. I don't know, that would be a pretty neat thing that you can use for the arc. That stat will be very important, because if you have it, your troops attack another troop, they slow down, and it helps for the arc. I think this is actually a good idea. If you hold the Shine of Life, change the name, maybe not Shine of Life, Shine of Mood, I don't know. If you hold that, your troops gonna slow down enemy troops by 10, 15, 20%. Work on that, but I think this is very nice. It's very strategical then. It becomes very strategical instead of being like that now, that is completely useless for a top alliance. The other suggestion that I have for the Arc of Osiris, and this comes from a friend of MB, BTG, is to make the obelisk closer to each other. Because closer obelisk will mean closer cities, will mean a higher pace rate in terms of the match, more fun, and actually a chance for real go for the obelisk, which is not possible now. Another thing that I will do is to raise a little bit the capacity of the outpost, so we can say, let's say 1 million, so we can put three marches full inside and then go around, and that's it, guys. These are my suggestions, the basic suggestions I had, and everything else. JVM gonna win the league, I repeat, 100% sure. If you enjoyed, like the video, subscribe and share to everyone else. See you soon with another video on Rise of Kingdoms.